Hello students, welcome to my channel. In my today's session, I am starting second chapter of standard 8 NCERT, that is rational numbers. Very important chapter, students, please give your full attention. Already in your previous classes you have learnt what are rational numbers. Okay. So before that rational numbers, I want to give some introductory part, that is some introduction for the rational numbers. I'll explain you. You know already natural numbers. See, natural number set is denoted by n, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. This is, these all are natural numbers. And you also know that whole numbers, they are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the difference between natural numbers and whole numbers? In the whole number set, 0 is included. In the natural number set, 0 is not there. This is the main difference between the natural numbers and whole numbers. And next comes integers. I is equal to, see here, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. See here, this is the reference point 0 or originating point. From here to left side all the negative integers, right side all the positive integers. This set is called as a set of integers. It is denoted by I. Then the next set, that is called as rational numbers, is denoted by Q. In this rational number set, here set of N will come, W will come and I. This is big set. It is very very big set. Here we can get the natural numbers, whole numbers and integers also we can get here. This is very very big set of numbers. In this big set all will come. Now let us see the properties of rational numbers. Okay, properties of rational numbers. First, already you know the definition of rational numbers, that is numbers which can be expressed in the form of P by Q, they are called as rational numbers, where P and Q are integers. Q must not be equal to 0. This is definition. Again, later on I will come to this definition once again. But now you know natural numbers, you know whole numbers, you know integers. So rational numbers also, just I said about the definition. Now properties, you know some properties are there in the mathematics. In that, the first property is closure property. First we will see whether the closure property is holding good for whole numbers or not. Okay, whether the whole numbers satisfy the closure property or not, we will see. What is the closure property? Now we will see. First, for that operation we will take, which are the four fundamental operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. First we will take one by one operations, numbers and remarks. Then for what numbers you have to take? We have to take for the whole numbers. Which are the whole numbers? See, whole number set is here. It is there. Now let us see. First we will take addition. Okay. Under the addition operation, now one, two numbers we will take. 0 plus 5 is equal to 5. Closure property says that when we add two numbers, the sum also should be in the whole number set. Yes, 0 is a whole number, 5 is a whole number. When we add them, we get again 5. 5 is in the whole number set. So this is what, or not only this, suppose 4 plus 8 is equal to 12. 4 is a whole number, 8 is a whole number. When we add them, the sum also will be in the whole number set. That means that whole numbers are closed under addition. numbers are, whole numbers are closed under addition. Closed under addition. That means when we add two whole numbers, the sum also will be whole number. That is closure property. Okay, that is under the addition. So in general, how can we write? See, A plus B is equal to C, where A and B are whole numbers, C is also whole number. This is in general form. Okay, in general, A plus B is a whole number. Then for any two whole numbers, A and B, this also whole number. The same way now we'll take for the subtraction. The next fundamental operation is subtraction. We'll take subtraction. See now, 4 minus 6 is equal to minus 2. You know it's minus 2 is not there in the whole number set. That means whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. Whole numbers are, this is numbers, whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. That means here on subtraction we have to get one number. That number should be in the whole number set. In the whole number set, negative numbers will be not there. So whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. Then next comes multiplication. The next operation is multiplication. See now, 3 into 5 is equal to 15. Yes, 3 into 5 is 15. 15 is in the whole number set. Then 0 into 9 is equal to 0. 0 is in the whole number set. Yes, that means whole numbers are closed under multiplication. Whole numbers are closed under multiplication. Okay. So then one more, the last operation is, what is that? Division. The last operation is division. Now let us see division. See here, 5 divided by 3 is equal to what? 5 by 3. 5 by 3 is there in the whole number set? No, it is not there. So what we have to write? Or we can take 1 divided by 2. 1 by 2. This is also not there in the whole number set. That means that whole numbers are not closed. Whole numbers are not closed under division. This is what first closure property we have tested for whole numbers. In the same way, now closure property we will test for integers. You know what are the integers? In the integers, we get positive and negative numbers along with the zero. So for the integers we will try. Closure property, now we try for the whole numbers. In this, only addition and multiplication are closed under the addition and multiplication. Whole numbers are closed under addition and multiplication, not for subtraction and division. The same closure property we will try for the integers. integers. Now the same type we'll do, then it is more clear for you all. That is operation numbers remarks. Okay, then the first operation will take, that is, you know already, addition. This is the first operation, fundamental operation, that is addition. Okay, in the addition, see, integers means here negative numbers also will be there, positive numbers also will be there. So first we will take 1 positive minus 4 plus 1. What will be the answer? Minus 3. Yes, minus 4 plus 1, we get minus 3. Minus 3 will be in the set of integers, that is negative integer. That means that integers are closed under addition. Integers are closed under addition. Integers are closed under addition. Like that, you can take so many examples also in this. Then subtraction we take. The next operation is subtraction. Next operation is subtraction. See, in the subtraction, 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. Minus 4, minus 2, that is minus 6. See, both are integers. One is positive, one is negative. Both are in the set of integers. That means integers are closed under subtraction. Closed under subtraction. Then the next fundamental operation is multiplication. Next fundamental operation is multiplication. See, multiplication also closed only, because see, minus 7 into 4 will take. Minus 7 into 4 is minus 28. Or 8 into 5 is 14. Or minus 3 into minus 4, that is plus 12. See, in each case, minus 28 is an integer, 14 is an integer, 12 is an integer. So integers are closed under multiplication. Closed under multiplication. Then division will take now. Division, see. Division. Now we'll take 2 divided by 3. How can we write 2 by 3? 2 by 3 is not there in the set of integers. Okay? That means division is, sorry, integers are not closed under division. Like this, the closure property we have tested, or we have seen the result for the whole numbers and the integers. Now the same way we can see the rational numbers. What about the rational numbers? See, now just if you want to copy, you can copy this. Thank you.
we continue the closer property for the rational numbers. Closer property for rational numbers. See, you know already what are rational numbers. Rational numbers are those which can be expressed in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers. Q must not be equal to 0. This is what definition of rational numbers. Let me now take the same way what we have done now for the whole numbers and integers. The same way, let us see whether addition, subtraction, multiplication and division are closed under rational numbers are closed under this all operation or not. We'll see now. Okay, one by one. First we'll take addition. First we'll take addition. First we'll see for the addition. We'll take two rational numbers. We'll take two rational numbers. Suppose those rational numbers are 3 by 8 plus minus 5 by 7. So when we add these, the sum we are going to get. That sum also must be a rational number. Whether that sum is a rational number or not, we'll see now. See now, here 8 and 7 is there. First we'll take, remove this bracket. 3 by 8 plus into minus minus 5 by 7. Then what will be the LCM? LCM will be 56. So 8, 7 is 7, 8 is 7, 3 is 21. Minus 8, 5 is 40. The answer is minus 19 by 56. Minus 19 by 56. Yes, it is a rational number. Okay. Sum of two rational numbers is also a rational number. That means rational numbers are closed under addition. This implies that rational numbers are closed under. This implies that rational numbers are closed under addition. Closed under addition. Now, in the same way, we'll see for the second one, that is subtraction. Subtraction of two rational numbers, we'll see now. Subtraction of two rational numbers. What is that? See now, the difference of minus 5 by 7 minus 2 by 3. What will be the LCM? LCM is 21. 7, 3 is 3, 7 is minus 15, minus 14. The answer is minus 29 by 21. It is a rational number. That means that this implies that rational numbers are closed under subtraction. The same way we'll have it for multiplication. For multiplication, product. Now see, minus 2 by 3 into 4 by 5. We'll see. See now, in the multiplication, we no need to take the LCM. Direct multiplication from numerator to numerator, denominator to denominator. Minus 2 into 4 is minus 8. 3 into 5 is 15. Minus 8 by 5 is also a rational number. So this implies that rational numbers are closed under multiplication. Closed under multiplication. Then now we'll see the last one, that is division.
Division, we'll check it.
See here, minus, that is for division. Minus 5 by 3 divided by 2 by 5. You know how to do minus 5 by 3. If it is division, we have to convert it to multiplication. 2 by 5 will be 5 by 2. This is nothing but minus 25 by 6. Yes, it is a rational number. Okay. Suppose, one more I will take and show you. See, 0 by 1 divided by 5 by 2. See here, 0 by 1 is 0 into 2 by 5. This is also 0. Okay, 0 is a rational number. Suppose 5 by 1 into 1 by 0. See, what is this? 5 by 0 by 1. If you take like this, 5 by 1 into 0 by 1 is 1 by 0. This is 5 by 0. This is not defined. Something by 0 is always not defined. That is infinity. So, rational numbers are not closed. Rational numbers are not closed under division. Under division. This is what closer property we have tested are for whole numbers, integers and rational numbers. Then the next property is commutative property. So that property we'll see in the part 2.